Hello, Ace. This is RetroTK2 and welcome to this Unity tutorial. Today we're creating a version control Unity project. I'll show you how to set up your Unity project for Git and add a Unity specific Gitignore file. I'd advise you to watch my version control videos from the start before watching this video, Ace. So let's get started. I set up a local remote repository to simulate an actual remote repo. If you'd like to learn how to set up an actual remote repository, you can check out this video, Ace. Launch Unity and create a new project. Here I'm creating the project on the desktop base, but feel free to save it wherever you like. Let's set up our project for Git. Click Edit, Project Settings, Editor. Click the drop-down button beside Mode under the version control label and select Visible Meta Files. According to this Unity answer, if you don't do this, the next person or computer who gets the solution will generate new meta files because it can't find any. Each meta file has a certain GUID which is used to reference to the correct assets. The next time anything searches for this reference, it won't be found and your scene will be broken. For scripts, you will get something like missing script. This can also be important when you're updating Unity packages, Ace, but we'll talk about that a little later. Click the drop-down button beside Mode under the Asset Serialization label and select Force Text. Doing this means we'll be able to merge certain Unity objects together, such as two scenes. We'll discuss this further in a future video, Ace. Now the Unity side is set up, we're ready to make our project a Git repository. Launch SourceTree. Click Clone New and click the Create New Repository tab. Add your project's path to the destination path text field, Ace, and click Create. Immediately, our unstaged file area is flooded with all our project files from the Unity project. A lot of these files don't need to be version controlled, Ace, and can be added to our Unity specific Gitignore file. Open your project folder, right click, and click on New Text Document. Type .gitignore. Press Enter and click Yes. This will create our Gitignore file, Ace. Now we need to populate it. Open Chrome, type Unity Gitignore into the search field, and it should be the first link. I'll also put a link in the description and add a copy of the Gitignore file to my channel files. There are plenty of examples of Unity Gitignore files on the internet, Ace, so don't feel limited to just this one. Copy the text, open our Gitignore file and paste the text into it. Save and close the Gitignore file. Now if we head back into SourceTree, you'll see our unstaged file count goes from 92 to 18. Your count may vary depending on your Unity version, Ace. Stage and commit. Now we need to connect our project to a remote repo. Here I'm copying the path to my local remote repo, Ace, but you'll need to get the URL for your remote from your Git host. Head back into SourceTree and click the Settings button in the top corner. Click the Add button. Give your remote a name, paste your remote's URL into the URL path text field and click OK. Click OK and push the changes to the remote repository. Our Unity project is now under version control, Ace. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, Ace. Feel free to download my channel files. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any of your Git experiences. Thank you for watching, Ace, and I'll see you in the next video.